tolerated in the world community.
والحقيقة حتى اتهام بلدي كان مفاجأة كبيرة لي وهذا خلاني أنا تعبت أنا وعائلتي صراحة تعبت بشكل كبير.
أنا لا نرى تواجدي في مالطا كانت فرصة لي لأن أقوم بعمل إرهابي مثل هذا الذي يتهموني بها. علاقاتي داخل مالطا معروفة و يمكن لأي شخص أنه هو يسأل علي.
I know him. I know he will never hurt a fly. But it was a shock that it was put on him. They put his name. You know, you can't believe it.
I don't really believe it that he done it. You know, not even all the Maltese that knew him ever believed that he did it.
It was unbelievable. I mean, everybody. They had the same opinion in a way. They, you know, he's not such a person. He's so soft that they give him a nickname, the egg. You know, that means he's very, very soft.
وأنا ليست لدي إشارة على ذلك لأنني مستغرب ماذا أريد أن أقول. دولة اتهمتني باطلا. أنا لا أعرف الأسباب. أنا لو كنت أعرف لا ذكرت لكم.
The Roman theater in Sabarata, Libya, hocked and sandblasted. In its splendor, when Africa provided the grain for Rome and the Libyan, Septimus Severus was Roman emperor, 1500 years before the birth of the American Republic. Two Libyans, cast without ever auditioning, have now become players in a new play with a very old plot. White hats and black hats. The play goes like this. Basit Maghrabi, terrorist one, a frequent traveler in his work for Libyan Arab Airlines, always using his own passport, arrives in Malta and using a false passport checks into the Holiday Inn, one of the only two luxury hotels in Sailima not owned by Libya.
سوف في المحكمة سوف تكون هناك إجابة واضحة لهذا الموضوع يعني.
In the meantime, second terrorist Lamine Sima is rigging a bomb in the Libyan Arab Airlines office. Could it be this office? Or perhaps this one? Using Semtex he has stored there amongst the Libyan, Maltese and other employees and of course Mr. Bollier's device.
أنا لا تدخل يعني عقلي أن نستعمل متفجرات أو نقوم بتخزينها داخل مكتب من مكاتب خطوط طيران داخل المطار.
هذا المكتب يشتغل فيه ليبيين ومالطيين، فكيف يمكن وضع مادة زي هذه خطيرة جدا في هذا المكتب، وكيف يمكن السكوت عنها إذا كان راها أي حد منا؟
When the Great War Fleet docked in Malta, the warship tenders would unload sailors looking for what every sailor seeks at the foot of the Sailima street. Now shoppers look for other kinds of cheap deals.
What was more valuable than the suitcase and the tracing of the suitcase were the clothes in that suitcase. There were some baby clothes, there was an umbrella, there were different items that were not really consistent with having come from this one suitcase, you know. You figure a suitcase from a man who was owned by a man would have just men's clothes in there. Here was a suitcase that had several different items in there, from babies to adults to casual items. It turned out that apparently, as I recall, that one of the items of clothing, not to be specific, was traced as a suitcase might have been.
Bomb-damaged clothes made in Malta had been found in the Pan Am 103 debris, so secret agent Maghrabi must have scrambled up and down this shopping street from shop to shop, finally buying baby clothes, pants in different sizes, an umbrella at Mary's house. Tony Gauci and Paul Gauci, the brother owners. Maghrabi, truly incognito, not as lucky as Dalkamani and Krisat in Noyce, had not been filmed. So over 2 years, Tony will make 18 separate statements, Paul four to the FBI and Scottish police as they try to get the brothers to identify the clothes buyer. 50 years old, 6 feet, hefty, full hair, had been there before, had been there again, had been there once, had seen him in a bar several months later. The baby clothes had a sheep's head, no, an entire lamb embroidered. I will sign, though I do not read English. 20 years older than the photo fit. Similar, but not identical. Maybe, perhaps, like him, but not fully like him. Like the man in the Sunday Times. Lamine Fima then steals Air Malta luggage tags, after duly noting the English word in his diary.
أول شيء أنا فترة الحادثة لم أكن أشتغل داخل المطار حسب ما هي الصورة واضحة أمام العالم. بالنسبة للتاجز موجودة بطاقات الشنط موجودة في المطارات بشكل لست أنا اللي الوحيد اللي ممكن نصل إليها. قد يصل لها أي شخص آخر أو من السهل. بل موجودة في جميع مكاتب الخطوط الليبية. لماذا لا يقول بأنها هي سرقت من داخل مكتب الخطوط الليبية في مالطا في ليبيا.
And then arranges for an unaccompanied bag full of the medley of Maltese clothes and the bomb to be put unaccompanied on an Air Malta flight. The bag going through three airport security systems, traveling through a European winter with unpredictable flight delays, the explosion capable of occurring anywhere on Pan Am 103, in the air, over land or sea, even in the airport. Our play began as a tragedy. Has it now become a comedy? With two stooges, not three?
If a device had been infiltrated into the system at Malta, it would have been necessary for that device to have been carried in an aircraft on the sector from Malta to Frankfurt, to have gone through a handling process, been carried on an aircraft for the sector from Frankfurt to Heathrow, and then timed to detonate during the final sector, Heathrow to New York, presumably whilst the aircraft was over the ocean to avoid discovery, forensic evidence. And one has to say, are terrorists idiots? Don't terrorists plan to have a reasonable degree of success of doing it? We looked at something else, and it's a matter of public record of the bomb-making activities and the group that had been active in Germany, in Neuss at the time. There's all the publicity, the documentation of that. So we had to consider, do you think it's likely that a terrorist group that has managed to manufacture a very sophisticated